Okay, good evening, good evening, good evening mga LCTC reviewers namin, no? So, welcome po sa ating Friday Night Drills here at LCTC Review Center. Again, with me, Sir Gilmore, para sa ating Friday Night Drills. Okay, bago po natin simulan ang ating live drills and lectures sa gabing ito, I just wanted to say congratulations po sa mga pumasa na mga reviewers natin sa LCTC. Okay. So congratulations, congratulations po. Nagbunga lahat ng pagod, no? The invested time, money, and effort. Ayan. So nakuha na ninyo ang premyo. Okay. So talagang kailangan nating mag-invest ng time. Kailangan natin sometimes mag-invest ng resources. Okay. So kaya, no, sa mga nanonood sa atin ngayon na tumatangkilik sa ating Friday Night Drills, no? Salamat po at on March, we'll pray that you too will become a licensed professional teachers. Okay, and pasensya po na ngayon na po tayo nakapag-live ulit. Kasi nga na napaka-busy ng schedule, no? And dagdag pa yung internet connection, no? Unstable internet connection. Okay. So, ngayon po, sisimulan na ulit natin ang ating live drills and lectures para sa gabing ito. Okay. Congratulations in advance. Claim it. Napapasa kayo ngayon sa Let ngayong March. Okay. Sumari po kayong mag-comment ng inyong mga sagot. No? Okay. So hopefully, mayroon pa kayong mga natatanda, no? Okay. So last lecture natin, nag-stop tayo sa item 340. So proceed tayo sa item 341 and I think yung we prepared at least 341 to 425 items, no? I think. Okay. Sige. Ito. Uy, math. Math kaagad. But I think na-review na natin to, no? Nung mga nakaraan nating mga lectures. Okay. A ball is drawn at a random from a box containing 6 red balls, 4 white balls, and 5 blue balls. Find the probability that it is blue. Oh, pipili ka randomly. Sige. So what is the probability that you will be getting a blue balls out from the box containing 3 different colors? Sige, ano nga? Paano nga natin gagawin yun? So meron tayong formula, no? Tinawag natin yung probability formula, yung number of favorable outcomes over the total number of outcomes. Okay. So good evening po ulit sa mga nanonood sa atin. Live po tayo. No, maaari po kayong mag-comment. Huwag po kayong ma-pressure. Kasi maraming pumasa ngayong September. Okay. So sa March, papasa rin kayo. Okay. So, number of favorable outcomes. So, ang hinahanap is the probability of picking a blue ball. So, that is 5. That's the favorable outcome kasi mayroong 5 balls, no? So, ilan lahat yung outcomes, possible outcomes? We have 6 red balls, we have 4 white balls, that's 10. And we have, add the 5 balls, that's 15. So, the ratio will be 5:15. When we are going to convert that into a fraction, gagawin tayong fraction, 5/15, reduce to lowest term, 1/3. So, ang answer po sa item 341 is 1/3. Okay. So, pag nakakuha ng tamang sagot at natatandaan pa ang formula na ibinigay ko nung mga nakaraan nating Friday Night Drills, congratulate yourself in advance. Okay, ito po ang formula. So, S equals, hindi na naman makita, no? So, pakisulat na lang po, no? You get a pen and a paper at isulat nyo S or the probability equals N, yung numerator, which is the favorable outcomes, over T, the total outcomes. So, dito sa item 341, yung favorable outcomes natin is 5 blue balls. Okay? Kasi yung, yun yung pagpipilian. And total number of outcomes, yung lahat ng bola. Okay. So, that's one-third. The probability of picking a blue ball is one-third. Next item, 342. Sandali lang po, i-open ko. In how many ways can 5 girls be seated in a row of seats? Oh, permutation na naman. Okay, so na lecture na rin natin 'to, 'di ba? No? Na-discuss na natin. Okay. So tandaan yung formula, ito po. Ay, di na naman makita. So tandaan niyo po yung formula, permutation equals n factorial over the quantity of n minus r factorial. Okay? So yung n po natin ay yung 5 girls. Yung r po natin is yung 5 seats. So sabi sa formula, n minus r factorial. Okay. Sandali po, kukuha ko ng ball pen. Okay. Please excuse me for a while. Okay, so the permutation n factorial over the quantity of n minus r factorial. Sandali po. I'm going to remove. Ayan. So nakikita niyo po.
Wow.
Okay. So yan po ang formula. That's the quantity of n. Sandali po, kukunin ko yung background, virtual background para makita. Yan. Okay. Yan yung pong formula. Tandaan nyo po. Okay. The quantity. The quantity of n minus r factorial, yan po ang denominator, no? Ang tsaka yung numerator natin is yung n factorial. Okay, balikan natin yung given. Okay. So yung given po ay 5 girls, that's our n, and our r is 5. So ganito po ang mangyayari. 5 factorial over 5 minus 5 factorial. Okay. Yan po. So, ito ang mangyayari. Yung n natin, 5 factorial, yung n minus r factorial. So, cancelin natin yung ibaba, kasi 5 minus 5, 0, that's 5 factorial. So, 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Yan po ang factorial. Okay? Factorial po. 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So, 5 times 4, that's 20. Times 3, that's 60. Times 2, that's 120. Times 1, 120. So, ang sagot po, 120 times. 5 girls can be seated in a row of 5 seats 120 times. Tandaan po ang formula. Again, ito po. Okay. N factorial over the quantity of N minus R factorial. Klarong klaro. Okay. So, halimbawa po, for example, 5 girls in 3 seats. Okay. Bigay tayo ng example. Okay. So, n factorial, gawin natin yung formula, may divided by or over n minus r factorial. So, 5 girls, 3 rows. Okay, ito po yung bibigay nating example. Okay? 5 girls, 3 rows. Okay. So, ang gagawin natin, substitute natin, 5 factorial over 5 minus 3 factorial. So, 5 factorial over 5 minus 3, that's 2. So, that's 2 factorial. Yan po ang mangyayari. Okay. Then, expand the numerator. 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 factorial over 2 factorial. Bakit hindi na po natin kailangang i-expand si 2? Kasi alam natin, ang 2 factorial is 2 times 1. At yung denominator, 2 factorial, 2 times 1 pa rin. Simply cancel it out. So, ang matitira ay 5 times 4 times 3 lamang. And that is 60. Okay? Ito po. Kasi makancel yung 2 factorial, no? Cancel out 2 factorial. So, 5 times 4 times 3 na lang yung matitira. So, 5 times 4, that's 20. Times 3, that's 60. So, 5 girls can be seated in 3 rows 60 times. No? In a row of 3 seats, I mean. So, 60 times. Klarong klaro. Okay. Next, let's proceed. Good evening po sa mga nanonood sa atin ngayon. Okay, let's proceed to the next item. Okay, the highest form, the highest category in the classification of plants and animals, genus, species, phylum, or domain. Okay, the highest category in the classification of plants and animals is, so sa given po, domain. Okay, it's genus, species, phylum, or domain. Sa given po, ay domain yung pinakataas. No? Pero kung wala po ang domain, hanapin kingdom. Okay, so ito po. Okay, yan. Yan ay domain, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, then species. Okay. Again, domain, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species. So ang pinakataas na kategorya po, no, sa classification, no, is domain. Kung wala po ang domain, kingdom. Okay, tandaan po natin mga ka-LCTC, no, na papasa ngayong March. Okay. So, tandaan po natin, domain ang pinakamataas. Kung walang domain, kingdom po. Okay? Tandaan po natin. Okay? Tandaan po natin na domain ang highest category sa taxonomy. Kung wala ang domain, tandaan, kingdom. Okay, ang sa taxonomy. Okay? Sige. So, sino nga ulit ang father of modern taxonomy? Si Linnaeus. Okay. Father of modern taxonomy, sino? Si Linnaeus. Take note po. Si Linnaeus, ang father of modern taxonomy. Okay. Highest category in the classification of plants and animals, domain. Kung wala pong domain, kingdom. Okay. Next. Let's proceed. Okay, good evening po. Good evening. Good evening. So, good evening po sa inyo. Oy. Hello po. LPT na si Merlin. Self-review lang po ako and naka one take lang po. Thank you po sa YouTube channel niyo, no? Oy, thank you rin po. Oy, good evening sa inyong lahat. Salamat po sa panunood, no? At na nakatulong yung mga reviews, drills and lectures, no, namin dito sa LCTC. Okay. Mr. Arias. Oh. Si Mr. Dave, Sir Dave sa Cambalon, good evening. Good evening. Oy. Sir Clifford Arias, shout out, sir. Okay. So, thank you po. Okay. Sir Mac Froilan, good evening po. Oh, good evening po sa mga tumatangkilik sa atin every Friday. Okay. Sige. Sino nga ulit ang father of modern taxonomy? Linnaeus. The highest category in the classification of plants and animals, domain. Pag walang domain, kingdom. Tandaan. Okay. Next. Okay, let's proceed. In a university, the ratio of female professors to the male professors is 8:5. If there are 258 female professors, how many are male professors? Okay. Sige nga. Sige. So, given na yung female professor, no, 228 daw. And ang ratio ng female to female, I mean female to male, is 8:5. So kailangan na nating kunin ang value ng ratio nila. Okay, ito. Find the value of x. Kasi ito yung female professor, di ba? 8x equals 228. So 8 divided by 8 yung first, and then yung second is divide natin ng 8, cancel yung 8, matitira na lang yung x. Oy. Pag x na, wag mo nang itira. Tapon mo na. Okay. X equals, so 228 divided by 8. Oh. Ano? That's 36. Okay. Then the value of x must be substituted to 5. 5 times 36. That's 180. So, mayroong 288 female professors and mayroon ding 180 male professors. Kaya ang ratio is 8 is to 5. Ang tanong, how many are male professors? 180. Okay. Tandaan po. Pag yung total naman yung given, i-add mo lang yung ratio. I-divide mo ang total sa total ng ratio sa total number. Okay, for example, total number of professors. Okay, that's the value of x. Okay, para malaman kung ilan ba, okay, yung female professor or yung male professor. Okay, sige. Next, let's proceed. Which secretes bile that aids digestion? Is it the liver or the pancreas? Secretes bile that aids digestion. Take note po, yung pancreas, insulin ang sinisecrete, no? Pancreas secretes insulin to regulate blood sugar, or sugar level in the blood. Ito namang liver, bile yung kanyang isinisecrete, which aids digestion. Yung bile po ay stored in the gallbladder. Okay, take note. Okay, let's proceed. Ano nga ulit yung nagsisecrete ng insulin? Pancreas. Ng bile? Liver. Saan nga ulit stored yung bile pag sinecrete na ng liver? Sa gallbladder. Largest internal organ ng human? Liver. Okay, next. 346. Okay. Simplify 6 minus the quantity of 3 minus 4, positive 4, plus 11 plus 8. Take note the PEMDAS rule. So we need to solve first, no? Kailangan muna nating gawin yung nasa loob ng kahon. Okay. And the PEMDAS rule, parenthesis first, then multiply, divide, add, subtract. Left to right. So, kahit na minus yung nauna, 3 minus 4, hindi natin unang i-add yung 11 and 8 or 4 plus 11 kasi in the PEMDAS rule, nasa una yung addition kaysa sa subtraction. Okay? But, take note, left to right yung rule. Nauna yung subtraction, minus, gawin natin. The answer is letter B. Very good. Okay. So 3 minus 4, that's negative 1. Plus 11, that's 10. Plus 8, that's 18. No? 18. Si 18 ay nasa loob ng parenthesis. So gagawin nating negative 6. No? Negative positive 6 minus negative 18. That's negative 12. Okay, very good. Okay. Very good. Sarap naman pong pakinggan na may mga nakapasa na, no? Dahil sa pagre-review dito sa LCTC. Okay, lahat po ng mga lecturers ng LCTC ay are all doing their best, no? To guide and to share the knowledge, no? That may help possibly sa mga nangarap ding maging LPT. Okay. 347, the same rule applies. Okay. Ngunit, tandaan natin na aside from the PEMDAS rule, kailangan rin nating let us also be particular, no? In the sign. Okay? Kasi integers to. Okay. So, unahin pa rin natin yung nasa loob ng parenthesis. Itong si 2 minus negative 4. Rule ng subtracting integers. Change the sign of the subtrahend. Kaya itong si negative 4 magiging positive 4 and then proceed addition. Rule ng addition, add like sign, subtract unlike sign. Simple lang po. Okay, again, rule in subtracting integers, subtracting integers, change the sign of the subtrahend, itong negative 4 magiging positive, proceed addition, add like sign, and if it is unlike, subtract. Since 2 is positive and 4 here will become positive, based on the rule, magiging 6 plus 11, that's 17. Minus positive 6 plus 11, that's 6, 17 minus 8, that's 9. Si positive 9 ay magiging negative, negative 4. Thank you po. Okay, negative 4 ang sagot. Okay, so tandaan po natin ha, ang rule ng integers, no? When it comes to sign and na solving number in series, operations in series, the PEMDAS rule, the MDAS rule, left to right, subtracting integers, change the sign of the subtrahend, first change the sign of the subtrahend and then proceed addition. After changing the sign of the subtrahend, pag nagkaparehas yung sign, whether both are positive or whether both became negative, add. Pag after changing the sign of the subtrahend, nag-iba yung sign. Naging magkaiba yung sign ng dalawa, subtract automatically and use the sign of the bigger digit. Next. Simplify the quantity of 8x minus 24 over that's 2x squared, actually. 348. Wait lang po. Yeah, ito po. Susulat ko ulit kasi hindi na naman nakita yung x squared. Pasensya po. So simplify 8x minus 24 over 2x squared minus x minus 15. Okay, ito po yung given. So, 8x minus 24 over 2x squared minus x minus 15. Oh, yan po ang given. And we are tasked to simplify. Okay, teachers, tandaan po, pag simplify, it simply means reduce to lowest term. Okay? Iyan bang numerator na 8x minus 24? Masimplify pa natin? Maaari pa ba nating i-reduce? Okay? Kailangan natin kunin ang kanyang factors. Okay. Common factors. ng 8x minus 24 is 8. 8x di ba? Yan po ang factor ng 8x minus 24. Kasi pag i-multiply natin siya sa 8, magiging 8x minus 24. Okay? So, ang factors po ng 8x minus 24 is 8 and x minus 3. Okay. Now, let's try to factor out the denominator, which is 2x squared x minus 15. Oh. Let's proceed. Ito po ang factors niya. That's 2x squared minus 6x plus 5x minus 15. Sandali lang po. X minus 3 5 x minus 3. So ito po ang factors ng 2x squared minus x minus 15 is 2x plus 5 and x minus 3. Okay, yan po. Yan po ang factors ng 2x squared minus x minus 15. So, 2x plus 5 and x minus 3. Now, take note na yung denominator x minus 3 ay kaparehas ng numerator x minus 3. Cancel out lang po. So, ang matitira pag i-simplify po natin ay 8 over 2x plus 5. Okay. Yan po ang sagot. 8 over 2x plus 5. Okay. Kasi, makansil yung x minus 3 sa numerator at x minus 3 sa denominator. Now, you might be asking, paano ba na-factor out yung 2x squared minus x minus 15? Ito po yung technique na ginamit ko. Okay? I simply multiplied the numerical coefficient of the first term, which is 2, and the constant, which is negative 15, that's negative 30. Then, hinanap ko po ang factors ng 30. Okay? Factors ng 30, that's 2 and 15, x 6 and 5. And yung sum or difference ng factors na yon is equal to the second term. So, itong negative 6 plus 5 is equal to negative 1. So, pareha sa middle term, which is negative x, that is 1, negative 1. Okay? Then, kinumbine ko lang po yung magkaparehos ng term. Ito. So, 2x and 6 and 5x and 15. Kasi, itong 2x squared, ito yung factor ng 2x squared at negative 6x para makuha mo yung constant. Kasi itong 5x and negative 15, ito yung factor 5x minus 3. Sa 2x squared, minus 6x, ito yung factor, 2x, x minus 3. So, combine lang yung x minus 3, kaya ito yung lumabas. 2x plus 5. Okay? Claro. Next, let's proceed. If 50% of x is 20, what is 20% of x? So, we need to solve first this equation to find the value of x, to determine the value of x. No? So, in the given, 50% is the rate. And 20 is part of a whole that makes it the percentage. Okay? Itong x po is the base. So, ano nga ulit yung formula? Using the magic triangle, ito. So, P over B times R. Pag hinahanap yung percentage, magkatabi itong si B, which is the base and the rate. Okay? So, itong base, multiply natin sa rate. Iyong given, hinahanap si base. Nasa ibabaw si percentage, nasa ibaba naman si rate. Kaya, 20 divided by 50%. Okay. Yung 50%, gawin nating decimal. 20 divided by 50, that is 40. So, the base here is 40. Hindi yan yung hinahanap. Kasi may karugtong pa yung tanong. What is 20% of x? Alam na natin that the value of x is 40. What is 20% of 40? Okay? 20% of 40. So, multiply lang natin. 40 times 0.20 equals 8. No? So, take note po, hindi yung base ang hinahanap, kundi ang percentage ng x if hinahanap ang 20% nito. Okay. So, we solve first the value of x to determine the base. Okay? And use the value of that base to solve for the percentage in the second question. Okay. Let's proceed. Okay, half of the celestial sphere is called blank. Ano po ang tawag? Tandaan, ang tawag po ay hemisphere. Ito pong Jovian planets ay tinatawag na outer planets or gas planets or the giant planets. Pag sinabi pong terrestrial planets, inner planets po kasi may land surface po sila. Okay. Tawag ng celestial sphere, half of a celestial sphere, hemisphere. Kaya mayroon tayong northern hemisphere or southern hemisphere. Okay, next. The mean of an x and negative 5 is 10. Pag sinabi po nating mean, average po. Okay, so for example, you have 4. Set of values, i-add mo lang yun and divided by the number of values. So, 4. Okay. Say, for example, we have 2, 4, 6, and 8. Okay. So, 2 plus 4, 6. 2, 4, 6, 8. So, 2 plus 4, 6, plus 6, 12, plus 8, 20, divided by 4, 5. Yan po ang mean. Itong sa given, the mean of an x and negative 5 is 10. What is the value of x? So, i-add natin x plus negative 5 equals 10. Paano nga ulit natin makukuha ang mean? I-divide by the given number of values. Ang given number of values, dalawa lang, x and negative 5. Ito yung resulta. Ay, sulat ko. Okay. So, ito yung mangyayari. X plus negative 5 equals 10 divided by 2. Ito po. Kasi nga, sabi ko kanina, add natin yung given set of values to get the mean divided by the number of values. Is a given x and a negative 5 lang. So, dalawang values lang ang that must be added in order to get the 10, which is the mean of the given values. No? So, x plus negative 5 equals negative 10. So, divide by 2 muna natin. Then, simply cross multiply. Okay. Kasi itong 10 may imaginary 1. Cross multiply lang natin. So, 10 times 2, that's 20, equals x, and times 1, that's x, no? Plus x times negative 5, that's still negative 5. Okay. Ito yung mangyayari. Cross-multiply after cross-multiplying. So, 20 equals x plus negative 5, transpose 5. So, 20 plus 5 kasi yung negative sign, pag i-transpose mo, magiging positive. Pag positive, pag i-transpose mo, magiging negative. Take note. So, x is equal to 25. Okay. Oh, ingon nila, tinambanon daw. Oh. Let's check. Using tinamban method, no. Sa mga Bisaya, tinamban. If the value of x is 25, based on our solution, 25 plus negative 5, kasi pag mean nga, add natin. 25 plus negative 5. Sabi ko kanina, the rule of adding integers, add like sign, subtract unlike sign. So, itong positive 25 at itong negative 5, subtract natin, even if we are trying to add, because that's the rule of adding integers. Note po. Okay? So, 25 plus negative 5, 20 na lang. I-divide pa natin ang 2 kasi we're trying to find the average or the mean. Take note, the mean is simply the average. So, 20 divided by 2 is 10. So, our answer, the value of x is 25, is checked. Take note. Okay. So, nakakuha ba yung mga nanonood? No, nakakuha ba ng tamang sagot yung mga nanonood? Okay. So, maaari niyo po itong reviewin ng paulit-ulit, no? Para po makakuha kung paano gawin, no, ang solution. Okay. Sige, next item po. Good evening. Good evening. Okay, next, the sum of the sides of all of a polygon is sum of the side daw. Sum of the side. O, ano yan? Pag sinabi nating sum, perimeter po. Pag sinabi nating total space taken by a flat object, that's area. Take note. Again, pagsampo ng sides perimeter, simply add all the measures or the lengths of the sides of a given polygon if you are tasked to find the perimeter. Pag area po, total space taken up by a flat object. Okay. So mayroon pong mga formula, no? Paano natin kukunin yung area? Okay. Tandaan po, mayroon pong formulas. So say for example, sa area ng square, S squared. Sa area ng triangle, that's 1/2 base times height. Sa area ng rectangle is length times width. Sa area ng trapezoid, 1/2 base 1 plus base 2 times height. Okay? So, sa area ng sphere or circle is pi r squared. Ganun po, may mga formula. Okay. I think I've prepared some pictures. Sana po ma-view dito kasi that will be part sa discussion natin ngayong gabi. Okay. Sum of the sides of all the polygon, tandaan po, perimeter. Okay. Daan, tandaan. Pag sinabi natin half of the celestial sphere, that's hemisphere. Pag sinabi nating outer planets, Jovian. Pag sinabi nating inner, terrestrial. Very good. Okay, pag sinabi nating sum of all the sides, perimeter. Pag sinabi nating taken space, total space taken by any shapes, no, flat shapes. Oh. Area. The highest classification of animals and plants based on taxonomy, that's domain. Kung walang domain, kingdom. Father of modern taxonomy, Linnaeus. Okay, very good. Okay, very good, very good. Sige. Pag sinabi nating average, mean. Okay, next, let's proceed. Okay, all right triangles are, is it equal, supplementary angles, complementary angles? Pag sinabi natin all right angles are equal, supplementary angles or complementary angles? Pag sinabi natin right angles, the measure is equivalent to 90 degrees. Lahat ng right angles po magkaparehas ng measurement 90. Hindi pwedeng mag-iba. So, right angles are all equal. Pag sinabi po nating supplementary angles po, pag ang sum ng total angles will be 180. Say for example, ito. I'm going to draw supplementary. Wait lang po. Okay. Oh, ito po. So, in the given, angle ABD measures 150 degrees. 130. Ito namang katabing angle niya, angle DBC measures 50 degrees. Di ba ang total ng dalawang angles, angle ABD and angle DBC is 180. Therefore, those angles are supplementary. Tandaan, supplementary angles po pag ang sum or the total measure of the given angles is 180 degrees, that's supplementary. Pag sinabi namang complementary, complementary angle gani, ang sum 90 degrees. Okay? Pag ang total sum ng dalawang angles or more, complementary, pag equal to 90 degrees. Pag equal to 180 naman, supplementary. Okay, so good evening sa mga nanonood sa atin ngayon. Okay? Again, ano po ang measure ng right? Ano po ulit ang measure ng right angles? 90. Pag sinabi nating acute angles, less than 90. Pag sinabi nating obtuse angles, greater than 90. Okay? Take note. Pag sinabi nating supplementary angles, ang sum ng measurement ng dalawang angles ay 180. Complementary, 90. Okay. Let's proceed po sa next item. The altitude of the base of a triangle is 24 meters and 5 meters respectively. What is its area? Altitude po, 24 meters. The altitudes of the base of an angle are 24 meters and 25 meters respectively. What is its area? Okay, draw natin. Yung base daw, 5 meters. Yung altitude naman, 24. Yan po. So, ang formula po sa pagkuha ng area ng triangle is area of a triangle equals base times height over 2, or sinabi kong 1/2 base times height. Okay? So kasi multiply mo yung base saka yung height and still divide it by 2. Okay. So multiply natin 24 times 5. That's 120 divided by 2, 60. So ang square ng, the area of that given triangle whose altitude is 24 meters and with a base of 5 meters is 60 square meters or 60 meters square ang area. Tandaan po. Okay, there you go. Area sa square, S squared. Isang side lang kasi all sides are equal. Simply square it. No? Times, multiply it by itself. Yung rectangle, length times width. Yung triangle, ito na, 1/2 base times height or base times height divided by 2. Area ng circle, pi r squared. Yung r is the radius. Or from the center of the circle to any points of the circle. That's the radius. Pag sinabi namang diameter, from any point passing through the center and to the opposite point of the circle, diameter, kalahati. Pag given yung diameter, wala yung radius, divide the diameter by 2. That's your radius. the parallelogram, base times height, trapezoid, sabi ko kanina, base 1 and base ha, base 1 and base 2. So ito yung AB, no? Sa baba, yung parallel line, up and down, that's the base, base 1, base 2, or A and B. Yung height po, from the base 1 to base 2. Okay? Then, divide it by 2. Okay. Excuse me for a while. Okay, okay. Good evening po, once again. Okay, next item. O ito, denotasyon or konotasyon. Okay. Pag sinabi nating denotation or denotation in English, literal meaning or yun pong meaning which can be taken out from the dictionary. Ito namang connotation is created meaning. No? Sige. So, just understand the kuan, the sentence. Huwag kang makisama kay Zoilo dahil buaya siya. Ang salitang buaya ay tumutukoy sa kahulugang letter B, konotasyon. Tama po. Konotasyon, given meaning. Hindi yung literal na buhaya ang being specified here. Hindi ito denotasyon or denotation in English. Okay. Tandaan, pag sinabi nating literal meaning or meaning na nakukuha natin sa dictionary, that's denotation or denotasyon. Pag given meaning naman, or iba yung pahiwatig, connotation or connotation. Okay, let's proceed. Item 356. Okay. Ano ang tawag sa tatlong magkakasunod na tuldok na ginagamit upang ipabatid ang na may bahaging hindi sinipi? Okay, tama na naman si Miss Avacon. Miss yata to, no? Letter A, ellipsis. Okay. Yung synthesis, buod, no? Or your generalization. Okay. So pag sabing ellipsis, mayroon kang hindi sinipi. Just part, no? Kinuha mo yung part, saka mayroon kang pinutol mo, no? Okay, so lalagyan mo ng tatlong tuldok. I miss po. Okay. Sige. I hope you are enjoying po sa lecture natin, no? And drills natin ngayong gabi. Okay. Next, 356, ellipsis ang sagot. Okay. Next, item 357. Sa anong bahagi ng pananaliksik matatagpuan ang mga kaugnay na literature at pag-aral or literature review? Sa bahagi ng research? Okay. Take note sa chapter 2 or kabanata 2. Ang makikita po natin sa kabanata 1 ay the introduction, no? The may 14 viewers po nananahimik. Okay. So good evening sa mga 14 viewers na nananahimik diyan. Okay. Ma'am Lorimay Badayos, letter B, tama po ang sagot. Letter B, ang literature review or review of related literature can be found in the chapter 2 of your research. Okay. I thank you po, Miss Avacon. Oh. Kondi yata tong apelido kasi con. Okay. Sige. Statement of the problem sa kabanata 1 din. Definition of terms, kabanata 1. Yeah. Ano pa? Makikita natin sa chapter 1. Scope and delimitation, makikita natin sa chapter 1. Okay. Yan po. Ang makikita po natin sa chapter 3 is the research, chapter 3 po is the research methodology. Research design, the research statistics, no? Yung research environment, the research respondents, okay. Yun po. Chapter 4 po is the discussion, no? The summary. Not the summary. Is the chapter 4 findings. No, diyan po dinidiscuss yung interpretation of the data and the analysis. Discussion, interpretation and the analysis of the data. Analysis and the interpretation of the data. Chapter 5 po is the summary of the findings, conclusions and the recommendations. Okay. Next. Which of the following when perceived causes action or reaction? Oy, stimulus. Okay. Pag yung tandaan mo, ma'am, Miss Avacon, no? Pag mayroon kang na-smell na para bang katulad ng perfume ng ex mo, stimulus 'yun, no? Natatandaan mo siya. Oh, 'di ba, Ma'am Lorimay? Oh, stimulus. Okay. Next. Fungi absorb the nutrients from dead organisms. In an ecosystem, what roles do they play? Oh, yung fungi. Eh, sige nga. Letter B. Very good. Ay, ang talino mo, ma'am. Mag-top notcher ka sa March. Okay. Saprophytes ang tawag sa kanila. Okay. Yung mga autotrophs, sila yung mga organisms that can produce their own food. Yung mga heterotroph naman, dependent. Kasi the heterotrophs cannot produce their own food. Okay. An autotroph is an organism that produces its own food. So, yung mga plants, algae is an autotroph. Take note po. Ang heterotroph naman ay organisms that does not make their own food. So, nag-rely sila, no, sa ibang organism, dependent. Animals, all types of animals, no? And fungi is also a heterotroph. Pag sinabi nating algae, autotroph yan. Pag sinabi nating phytoplanktons, autotrophs din yan. Pag sinabi nating fungi, heterotroph. Okay? Okay, very good. Pag sinabi nating fungi, heterotroph. Pag sinabi nating algae and phytoplanktons, autotrophs. Okay, good. Pag sinabi nating heterotroph, organisms that do not produce their own food. Pag sinabi nating autotrophs, these are organisms that produce their own food, that can produce their own foods. Okay, item 360. Sugar compounds such as monosaccharides, disaccharides, and polysaccharides are also classified as carbohydrates. Take note. Oy, very good. Top notch, sir. Kag yun, ma'am. I'm hoping and praying. Ma'am Lori May, very good. Carbohydrates. Okay. Ito. A toothpick can sit on the surface of water due to 361. Oh, palaging tinatanong sa LET. Surface tension. A toothpick, or sometimes ang tanong yung paperclip. Alico Grande, 31, 361A, check. Yung buoyancy po is an upward force, okay, exerted by a liquid. Okay, para lahat yung submerge ay lulutang. Oh, yan yung ibig sabihin ng buoyancy. Pag sinabi nating surface tension, it allows a paperclip or a toothpick to sit on the surface of the water. Okay. Pag buoyancy po, force, upward force exerted by water so that all submerged will float. Okay. Next. This demonstrates the feeding connections between all life forms, no? Yung mga nakaraang LET, ang keyword ng salitang ito ay intertwine. Letter B, food web. Pag sinabi nating food chain, linear, from producer, primary consumer, secondary consumer, then up to the last consumer, then apex predator. Food chain yan, linear. Okay. Feeding connections, or yung salitang intertwine, food web. Take note. O ito. The Kyoto Protocol, which requires countries to reduce greenhouse emission, is a practice that advocates 363. I'm waiting. Letter A, environmental protection. Very good. 363. Tama ulit kayo, mga ma'am and sir. Environmental protection. Klaro na sa tanong eh. Reduce greenhouse emission. That's environmental protection. Okay. Here, 364. Which is true of metalloids? Metalloids daw. Metalloids, which is true about metalloids, 364, have properties of both metals and non-metals. Tandaan po, metalloids. Okay, tinatanong din ito sa LET. Pag sinabing metalloid, it has both properties, metallic and non-metallic properties. Tama, semi-metals. Metallic and non-metallic properties. Correct. Semi-metals ang tawag sa kanila. Okay. It contains properties of both metallic and non-metallic properties. Metalloids or semi-metals. Okay. Next, let's proceed to the next item. An atom of silicon has a mass number of 28 and atomic number of 14. How many protons are in this atom? Okay. Protons daw, tanong. Okay. Atomic mass 28. atomic number 14. Okay. 365, letter B. Tandaan lang po natin, the atomic number is equal to the number of protons. And the number of protons is equal to the number of electrons. Very good. To get the atomic mass, okay, of an atom, add the number of protons and the number of neutrons. Paano ba natin kukunin yung neutrons? Sige, try. How to get? Oh, how to find the neutrons of an atom? Okay. Sige, ma'am. Miss Avacon. Okay, Miss Lorraine. Miss ba ito si Aliko? Or Mr.? Okay. Ito si Ems. O, key Ems siguro to. No? Sige. How to get the neutrons? Paano? Subtract the atomic mass the atomic number, no, or the protons, kasi equal lang yan, no? 14 po. 14, yes, yung protons and electrons. O paano nga natin kukunin yung neutrons? Minus the atomic mass, minus subtract it with the number of protons. Ha? Take note. So, atomic mass minus number of protons, that's number of neutrons. Okay. In an atom. Oh, neutrons. Sir Modesto Calvo. Hi, sir. Good evening. Ang idol ni nako na lecturer. Salamat kayo di ILPT nako. Oy, thank you, sir. Okay. Kailak po tagmunggos ano eh. No, so thank you din sa LCTC, di ba? Okay, so LCTC played an important role, no, sa lahat ng mga pumasa na nag-review dito sa LCTC. Okay, I am just one of the many lecturers, no, best lecturers po na nag-impart din ng kanilang mga expertise and knowledge, no, and techniques. Okay. Sige. Sir Modesto Calvo, congratulations po. Congratulations, congratulations. No, Modesto Calvo, LPT. Sir, thank you. Okay. So, again, the atomic number is equal to the number of protons and equal to the number of electrons. Okay. Pag sinabi nating neutrons, minus lang, no? Yung atomic mass minus the number of protons or the number of electrons, neutrons po ang sagot. Okay. Sir Modesto, thank you again, sir. And congratulations. Okay. Next, let's proceed. Okay, nakuha na ba yung teachers? Sige. O ito. The quantity of 3x to the power of 3 raised to the power of 3 is equivalent to, that's power to a power rule. Okay. Expand lang natin yung 3 raised to the power of 3, that's 27. And multiply the exponent of x to the power 3. 3 times 3, that's 9. So the answer is 27x to the power of 9. Okay. Tandaan po. Okay. Kasi ito yung Okay, ito po yung resulta. Okay, quantity of M raised to the power of A raised to the power of B. Simply multiply both exponents, A and B. Okay, tandaan po natin. 366, letter A. Sir Modesto, lipay kayo, sir. No? Thank you. Kaayo. Okay. Next item, 367. Which choice is equivalent to the quantity of 2a squared c quantity raised to the power of 2 over a c to the power of 3 or a c cube? Okay. Tandaan po natin. Yung power to power rule. So, expand natin yung numerator first, 2a squared c. So, 2 to the power of 2, that's 4. A to the power of 2, a squared to the power of 2. Multiply natin yung exponents, that's a raised to the power of 4. It's a given, walang 4. No? Okay. Take note na may a pa sa denominator. Di ba? Then, yung c, expand natin c squared. E may c pa na c cube sa denominator. Take note, in dividing, itong fraction divide to eh, di ba? In dividing numbers or terms with exponents, subtract the exponents. Okay lang yan, Ma'am Abacon, magkamali, no? At least, that's why we're here, to learn, no? And to review. Okay. So, A to the power of 4, A raised to the power of 4 na. Okay, kasi we did expand it, no? Yung A sa baba, cancel natin. Okay, so A to the power of 4 divided by A, that's A cube. So for A cube na ang answer. Paano pag may C negative 1? Kasi si numerator is C squared lang. Si denominator is C cube. So 2 minus 3 is negative 1. But sometimes, yung negative na exponent gagawing positive. Take note po, pag negative exponent, pag wala sa given, yung negative, gawin nating positive yung negative exponent. Okay? Ito po. Okay, to make the positive the negative exponent positive gawing denominator. So pag wala sa given yung 4a cube c negative 1, hanapin yung 4a cube over c kasi ginawa nilang positive yung negative. Lahat ng negative exponent sa numerator ibaba gawing denominator and change the negative exponent to positive. Take note po. Okay? Klaro? Sige. Another example. Ito po. Pag sinabi nating 2x squared y negative cube. O yan. Panibagong example. Pag negative, gawing denominator. Change the negative exponent to positive. So itong 2x squared y raised to the power of negative 3 magiging 2x squared y cube. Okay, tandaan po, huwag mali to. Baka, no? Yung sagot na ibibigay ng PRC ay walang negative, no? Imagsasanggarutot ka, no? toss a coin ka kung asan ba yung sagot. So, ngayon alam na natin na yung negative, maaaring gawing positive, lagay sa denominator. Okay. Sige, good evening po sa ating lahat. Next item, let's proceed. Okay, nakuha. Okay, yes, Ma'am Evacon, salamat po. No, nakuha mo na. Naglibog ka ganina, Ma'am Lurimi. O karon, nakuha na, itong balikon. Okay, balikan natin. Take note po ha. In dividing terms with exponent, subtract the the exponent. Okay. Pag positive, nasa taas. Pag negative, yung nasa numerator, ilagay sa denominator gawing positive. Okay, good. 369. Which of the following media's sound travels the fastest? Check. Solid. Letter A. Pero ang nilagay na item ni Ma'am Abacon, 369. Tama yung kanyang sagot, pero na-shadean niya yung item 369. 368. A. Very good. Okay. Nagbasa si Ma'am Eva ko ng questionnaire. Tapos na-shade niya sa 369. Ay nako. Mali pala. Okay, very good. But alam mo ma'am ha, yung sound travels fast in solid. Okay. Ay, balik na ito. An atom of silicon has a mass number of 28, an atomic number of 14. How many protons are there in this atom? 14. Take note po, atomic number is equal to the number of protons and equal to the number of electrons. Okay. Atomic mass minus the number of protons is equal to the number of neutrons. Number of protons plus number of neutrons equals atomic mass. Very good, Ma'am Lorime. Sige. Next. It is the height of the wave. Trough, amplitude, crest, wavelength. Height of the wave. Sige nga. Wave. Height. Letter C. Letters 370, letter C. Ma'am Lorraine, letter D. Ma'am Emski. Trough is the lowest point. Ang tinatanong po, height of a wave. Yung wavelength po is the length. No? So take note po, height of a wave, height of wave is called the amplitude. Yan po. Okay? Tingnan. So, crest, highest point. Trough, lowest point. Wavelength, length from the two highest points or two lowest points. Ang amplitude po is simply the height of a wave. From rest, okay, to crest or to trough. Amplitude. Take note, ang amplitude po is the height of a wave. Take note. Okay na po ba tayo? Amplitude, height. Okay? Pag sinabing wavelength, Pag sinabing wavelength, length from two highest points or from two lowest points. So, maaring crest to crest or trough to trough. Wavelength yan. Pag sinabi nating amplitude, height. Okay. From rest to crest and to trough. Okay. Good. So, ang sagot ay amplitude. Okay. Next, let's proceed. Move on na tayo. Okay. Kasi si Catherine at saka si Daniel ay naka-move on na rin sa kanilang breakup. Next item, 371. 371, letter B. Ay, namawi si Ma'am Avacon kasi yung item 368, nasagot niya sa item 369. Sayang. Ay, si Ma'am Lorime, naka 372 na. Item 371 pa tayo. It is a property of liquids characterized by its inability to flow. 371, that's viscosity. Okay. From the word viscous or thickness to flow. Oh. Yung opposite naman ng viscosity is fluidity. Okay. Very good. Next item. The distance between the two highest or lowest points of a wave. O ano yon? Ay, sa pag-type, joke lang po, Ma'am Lorime. Okay. O sige. Sagot. 372. Very good. Distance from two highest points. Crest or crest and trough to trough. Okay, very good. Ay, Ma'am Lorime, tama pa rin yung sagot mo. 372, letter B. It was a blessing from above. Okay. Alam nyo, nung nag-take ako ng board exam, 5 items yata. No, nagtaka ko bakit may sagot na ako tapos hindi ko pa nabasa yung mga questionnaire. Teachers, I believe in the power of prayers, no? Pray. Okay? Rely not on our own strength but no, as much as possible we should put more hope on divine providence. Okay? Alam nyo, 5 items ko, di ko na in-erase yung mga answers, no? Because when I read the questionnaires, believe me, all of those were correct. That's the power of prayer. Next, 373. What is the location on the Earth's surface that is directly above the place where an earthquake originates? Okay? Above daw. That's the 373. Correct. That's the epicenter. Yung fault po is simply the crack. Okay? Take note. So, 373, epicenter. Okay. So, alam nyo, we simply need to review eh, no? Kasi alam ko na it's, yes, the point of origin or the focus. Okay. Now, all of these are just a review. Okay? So, we simply need to refresh. Kasi sometimes natatabunan na, no? Okay. Point of origin, correct, the epicenter. Or, it's directly above the place where an earthquake originates. Very good. Next item. If no more solute can be dissolved in a solvent at a given temperature, then the solute is called? Anong tawag? If no more solute can be dissolved in a solvent at a given temperature, then the solution is called letter A, saturated, letter B, unsaturated. Tama po, saturated. Meaning, the solvent can no longer dissolve any solute. Okay. There are two types of solutions, no? Homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture. I mean, homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture. Itong homogeneous mixture, solution. Okay. Now, pag sinabi natin unsaturated, kaya pang mag-dissolve ng solvent. Ang solvent, the one that will dissolve, yung solute is the one being dissolved. Universal solvent, water. Take note. Universal solvent, water. Okay. Now, paano naman pag mixture or solution? Alcohol solution. Okay. Alcohol solution. Okay. Alcohol solution, water yung solvent, solute yung alcohol. Paano natin i-separate, no, yung mixture ng alcohol solution? Okay. Take note po that the boiling point of water in Celsius is 100 degrees. Okay? And the boiling point of ethanol is 78 degrees Celsius. Okay? Take note. 78 degrees Celsius po ang boiling point ng ethanol. So, pag natanong how to separate an alcohol solution is to boil the solution under 78 degrees Celsius heat. Okay? Kasi yung water will not reach its boiling point and will not evaporate. So, i-separate natin by evaporation. Okay. Then, pag na-boil yung mixture or the solution in a 78 degrees Celsius heat, alcohol will evaporate. Water will remain because it did not reach boiling point. Okay. The boiling point of water in Celsius is 100 degrees. Freezing point, zero. The freezing point naman, no? In Fahrenheit, 32 degrees. Boiling point, 212 Fahrenheit. Okay. Universal solvent, water. Very good. Sige, next item. The length of an Earth day is determined by the time required for approximately one Earth, is it rotation, revolution, sun rotation, or sun revolution? Very good. Tama. Ang isang buong araw ay Earth rotation. Very good. O, axial tilt of the Earth. Ilang degrees? Tilted daw. Axial tilt, 376. The axial tilt. Sige, I'm waiting for your answers. Axial tilt. Axial tilt of the Earth. Sige. I'm waiting. Axial tilt. 376. Sabi ni Mama Bacon, hindi na niya natandaan. Okay. Okay lang po kung hindi mo natatandaan. Okay. So, tama po kayo, Ma'am Loremay. Letter D po. 23.5 degrees. Okay. So, 23.5 degrees, the actual tilt of the Earth. Okay. Tandaan po natin yan, 23.5 degrees, actual tilt. Sayang yung 1. Oh, sagdi lang, ma'am. Huwag mo namang i-perfect yung gene ed. Okay. Mahirapan si PRC magbigay ng ano. Ang tawag dyan? May recognition ba pag na 100 mo yung gene ed? Okay. Baka meron, no? Pag highest ka sa gene ed. Okay. Ako talaga, nangarap ako na maging top notcher, no? But, you know, I'm still happy and very grateful na pumasa. It's not easy to pass the lab, no? Tell you. It's not easy to pass the lab. We need to spend time, no? Effort, money. Tagang nangarap akong mag-review noon. But wala akong pera kaya hindi ako nakapag-review. No? Okay. But everything is according to the plan of God. Okay. So kaya Ma'am Avacon, tandaan mo. Sabi niya na itelt ko yung Earth 23.5 degrees para mayroong season sa North Pole at saka South Pole. Okay. God is very intelligent. Okay. Next. The apparent rising and setting of the sun is viewed from Earth is caused by? Oh, you're lucky, very lucky na mayroon ng mga online reviews, particularly dito sa LCTC na free, no? And many lecturers give their expertise, no? Techniques, you know, their knowledge. Okay. Sige po. The apparent rising. Is letter the apparent rising and setting of the sun as viewed from Earth is caused by letter, take note po, letter A, Earth's rotation. Steady lang po yung sun. Okay. Hindi nagmumove. Okay. Yung mundo ang umiikot. Katulad mo, umiikot ka sa mundo niya. No? The apparent rising and setting of the sun as viewed from Earth is caused by Earth's rotation. Very good. Next item. Ay, hugot. Oh, sige. 379 or empty stomach, no? Mabuti yung enzymes pag walang laman yung chan. Okay. The correct way of eating fruits is when with an empty stomach. Okay, very good. Ma'am Janice, very good. Very good. Sir Lassis? Letter A. Sir or Miss Bato, di kayo ko kakita sa kuan photo ayang profile. Okay. Next, the earliest form of writing in the Philippines. Very good po. Sir po. Sir Lassis, good evening, sir. Sorry po. Okay. Sir, welcome po sa Friday Night Drills natin. Okay. Cuneiform is the earliest form of writing system all over the world. earliest form of writing, Cunaya form. Okay. Pero sa Pilipinas, mayroon pong debate by Bayin or Alibata ba? No? Okay. Yung unang sagot, Alibata. But kasi daw ang salitang baybayin ay hango sa salitang baybay or to spell. Okay, no? Okay. So, hieroglyphics, Egyptians. Okay. Alibata, letters, cuneiform, oldest form of writing. Okay. Take note po. Cuneiform, oldest system of writing. It was developed by the Sumerians, no? In Mesopotamia. Okay. Next item, 381. Okay, good evening po sa mga nanonood sa atin na hopefully po na mayroon kayong natutunan, no, sa gabing ito, no. I hope and pray that you will pass the March licensure examination for teachers. Okay. So, stick po tayo dito sa LCTC, ha. Okay. 381, tax imposed on every adult citizen of the Philippines is correct, community tax. Okay, so kukuha ka ng sidula. Okay. Pag sinabi natin property tax, buildings, no? Land. Okay, pag sinabi natin income tax, base sa ating income. Okay. Next item po. Who was the English naturalist who wrote the book entitled On the Origin of Species, in which he discussed his hypothesis that evolution resulted from natural selection, or the theory of natural selection? Okay. 382. The theory of evolution, or the natural selection, or the origin of species. No, kang Charles Darwin yan. Pag sinabi nating elliptical orbit of the planets or planetary motion, kanino yan? Fleming. Very good. Pag sinabi nating penicillin, kay Fleming yan. Paano na-discover yung penicillin? Paano na-discover? Serendipity. Okay. Or accidental discovery. Serendipity. Okay. Take note po. Okay, very good. Serendipity, Ma'am Abacon, accidental discovery by Alexander Fleming. Johannes Kepler, planetary motion, or kung walang planetary motion po, elliptical orbits of heavenly bodies. Okay. Very good. Tax imposed in every... Ay, nabalik na. Tax imposed. Uy, salit, alam nyo, sometimes 5 questions, no? Magbalik-balik, babalik at babalik. So it's a gift siguro, no, from PRC, na? So pag alam natin ang sagot, ay nako. Tumpak na tumpak. Sasayang-sasaya ka. You wanted 10 of those items na babalik at babalik. Magdadasal ka pa na, ay tag, bubalik pa ning a question kay nakatubag ko, no? So letter A, community tax. Okay. 384, which religious missionaries first arrived in the Philippines? 384. Which religious missionaries first arrived in the Philippines? Was it the Jesuits, the Franciscans, Augustinians, or the Dominicans? Okay. Take note po, Afajadara. Agustinians. Followed by Fa Franciscans. Ja Jesuits. Da Dominicans. Ra Recollects. Okay, sila yung huling pumarito. Okay. 384 po, Sir Lassis, ang unang religious missionaries, no, kasama ni Legazpi, were the Augustinians, followed by the Franciscans, then by the Jesuits. Pangatlo po ang Jesuits. Pang-apat ang mga Dominicans, and last, kasi mayroong limang mga religious missionaries dito pumarito, no, during the Spanish period. Panglima yung mga Recollects. Okay, next. He died in his young age, but he is honored now as the hero of the Battle of Tiran Pass. Sino? Oh, the young general, kilala sa pangalang na Goyong. No? Okay, sino? Hero of the Battle of Tiran Pass. Si Battle of Tiran Pass. Sino? Marcelo H. Del Pilar, Cayetano Arellano, ay, hello po sa 20 viewers natin, no? Thank you for staying with us. Okay, hero of the Battle of Tiran Pass, take note po. Letter C, si Gregorio Del Pilar. Si Marcelo H. Del Pilar po, kasama ni, hello po Ma'am Janice. Hi Sir Lassis, Ma'am Abacon, thank you po, Ma'am Lori May, Sir Alico. No? Ito pong si Marcelo H. Del Pilar kasama si Rizal at si Graciano Lopez Haina ay ang triumvirate of the propaganda movement sa La Solidaridad. Cayetano Arellano, the first Chief Justice of the Philippines during the American period. Gregorio Del Pilar, kilala bilang si Goyong or the Young General, hero of the Battle of Tiran Pass. No, yung pinalampas niya, pinauna niya si Aguinaldo at hinarap niya yung mga Amerikano. Antonio Luna po is the founder of La Independencia. Also a newspaper. Okay, next. Item 386. She is known for her love sonnets. She wrote, sino? Love sonnets. Kilala siya, no? Sa love sonnets na kanyang mga isinulat. Tama po. Si Ofelia Di Malanta. Ito pong si Ma'am Annabel, good evening po. Ito pong si Paz Marquez Benitez ay kilala sa kanyang sinulat na Dead Stars. Okay. So si Paz Marquez Benitez kilala sa kanyang isinulat na short story, Dead Star. Yes, Ma'am Abacon, Dead Star, no? Published in the Philippine Herald. Oh. And Dead Star is the first short story, Filipino short story written in English, no? Authored by a Filipino, short story written in English, Dead Star. Okay? Published in the Philippine Herald. Take note po. Okay. Dead Stars by Paz Marquez Benitez. Okay. Ito po, itong Dead Star, first short story in English written by a Filipino. Morning Star of English Literature. Sino? considered as the English star. Morning star, not English star. Morning star of English literature. Morning star of English literature. Sino? Kilalang kilala. Geoffrey Chaucer. Very good. Bard of Avon. Sino? Si William Shakespeare. Very good. Pag sinabi natin morning star of English literature, Geoffrey Chaucer. Pag sinabi natin Bard of Avon, Shakespeare. Pag sinabi natin author of Dead Stars, Paz Marquez Benitez. Known for her love sonnet, si Ofelia de Malanta. Very good. Known as the Kama poet, no, in the Philippines, and the first to be awarded as not national artist for literature, Jose Garcia Velia. Take note. Sige. Good. Next. She wrote the first Filipino modern English language short story, Dead Star, published in the Philippine Herald in 1925. Ay, claro. Paz Marquez Benitez. 388. Paz Marquez Benitez. Siya po ang sumulat ng Dead Star noon pong 1925 na published, no? Okay. Sige po. Who is Quijano de Martin in Philippine literature? Quijano de Martin? Quijano de Martin. Okay. Quijano de Martin, sino? 389. Si Nick Joaquin. Very good. Sige. Si Jose Garcia Velia po, known as the Kama poet. Take note. Okay. Si Nick Joaquin po ay kilala sa kanyang A Portrait of the Artist as a Filipino. Okay. Yan po ang palaging lumalabas sa let, no? Okay. Siya rin po ang sumulat ng A Question of Heroes. Okay, yan ang dalawang yan. Palaging lumalabas sa let. No, Portrait of the Artist as a Filipino ni Joaquin yan, and A Question of Heroes kay ni Joaquin rin yan. Okay. Sige. Kama poet, Jose Garcia Velia. Okay, very good. And the first, no, Filipino national artist for literature. Who changed, number 390, who changed the Independence Day from July to June? July 4, then to June 12. No, nung iwinagayway ni Emilio Aguinaldo, letter B, very good. Si Diosdado Macapagal, hindi Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, kundi Diosdado, ang kanyang ama, Diosdado Macapagal. Okay? Si Marcos po associated sa martial law. Okay. So, pag change ng independence, Philippine independence from July 4 to June 12, kay Diosdado Macapagal yan. Ang July 4 ngayon ay the Philippine-American Friendship Day. Okay. Note. Next, 391. Which property is illustrated by the equation MA plus MB equals M times the quantity of A plus B? 391. Sige nga. Okay. Good evening po sa mga nanonood sa atin ngayong gabi. So malapit na po tayong matapos 425 items lang, no? And we are now in 391. Sige na, answer, sagot. 391. Which property is illustrated by the equation MA plus MB equals M times the quantity of A plus B? Okay. Is it letter C? Is it letter B? Is it letter A, associative, commutative, the distributive, or the identity? Sige. Ano, wala nang sagot, wala nang ibang sagot. Take note. Ito po ay nagpapakita, the property being illustrated in item 391 is distributive property of multiplication over addition. Okay. So tama po si Ma'am Ems. Okay. Distributive property po yan. Tandaan po natin, ang commutative property po simply states that no matter how commutative property of addition. Okay. Kasi meron ding commutative property of multiplication, no? So sa addition, no matter how you change the order of the addends, it won't change the sum. Say for example, 4 plus 5 equals 9, 5 plus 4 is still equal to 9. Sa commutative property of multiplication, no matter how you change the order of the factors, the product is the same. Say for example, 3 times 4 equals 12. If you change the order of the factors, which is 3 and 4, if you change it to 4 times 3, the product is still 12. That's commutative. Balibali ra, no? Okay. Sa associative naman, groupings. Okay, no matter how you change the order of the groupings of the addends, the sum is the same. Okay. Sa multiplication naman, associative property of multiplication, no matter how you change the order of the groupings of the factors, the product is still the same. Okay. Example, sa commutative, 4 plus 3 equals 7, 3 plus 4 equals 7. Commutative property of addition. Pag multiplication, 4 times 3 equals 12, 3 times 4 equals 12. The product is the same. Binaliktad mo yung factors. Product is the same. Here, binaliktad mo yung addends. Product is, sum is still the same. Okay. Associative naman tayo. Associative property of addition. 3 plus 2 plus 5 equals 8. 3 plus, 10. 3 plus 2 plus 5 equals 10. Sandali lang po. Okay, here we go. Tandaan po. Sa associative property of addition, sa first grouping po, 2 plus 5 yung nasa parenthesis. So, the PEMDAS rule, unahin natin yung nasa parenthesis. 2 plus 5, 7. I-add natin si 3, 10. We change the order of the groupings. 3 plus 2, yung nasa parenthesis, PEMDAS rule, 5, plus 5, 10. So no matter how you change the order of the groupings of the addends, the sum is still the same. Punta naman po tayo sa, dito po, sa associative property of multiplication. So no matter how you change the order of the groupings of the product, of the factors, the product is still the same. PEMDAS rule, 3 times 2, gibax lang dalawa, nasa parenthesis, 3 times 2, 6, times 5, 30. Change the grouping of the factors, 2 times 5, 10, times 3, 30. That's associative property. Okay? Wala pong distributive property sa addition. Meron pong identity property, both addition and multiplication. Sa distributive property po, distributive property of multiplication over addition. Ito po. Say for example, 2 times 5 plus 2 times 3. 10 plus 6 equals 16. Okay, so two times five plus three, two times three. Okay, here. So ito po ang example sa distributive property of addition over distributive property of multiplication over addition. So, tandaan. Take note. 2 times 5 plus 2 times 3. 2 times 5 is 10 plus 2 times 3 is 6. 16. Okay, ginawa natin. We add 5 and 3. 8. Multiplied it by 2. Common 16. The same. So, M is common here. So, sa distributive property, may common digit. Okay? So, ang identity property ng addition, zero. Any number added by zero is always equal to itself. Okay, take note. Ang identity property naman sa multiplication, one. Any number multiplied by one is always equal to itself. Okay, take note. Next, let's proceed to item 392. Which of the following illustrates the associative property of addition? Oh, na-discuss ko na kanina, associative property of addition daw. Sige nga, comment kung may mga nanonood pa. Oy, si Ma'am Avacon, Miss Avacon na lang ba ang nanonood? Sige ma'am, saan dyan sa items ang nagpapakita? Which of the items no illustrates the associative property of addition? Ma'am MSK, very good. Ma'am Avacon, very good. Thank you. Letter A. So, no matter how we change the order of the groupings of the addends, the sum will still be the same. Very good. So, unahin natin to. 9 plus 3, that's 12. Plus 8, 20. 8 plus 3, that's 11. Plus 9, 20. It's the same. Yes, very good, Ma'am Janice. Very good, Ma'am Annabel. Next, item 393. Which of the following is not true? Not true daw. Letter A. 16 and 701 thousandths is less than 16 and 71 hundredths. Tama? Mali. Tama. Check. So it's true. Letter B. 53 and 23 hundredths is equal to 53 and 23 2,310 thousandths. Okay. So ang sagot ay ang hindi tama. Very good. Letter C. 25 and 500 thousandths less than 25 and 5 tenths. Okay? So, hindi yan greater than yung 25 and 25.500. Dapat equal yan. 25.500 is equal to 25.5. Kasi zeros, tatanggalin mo lang yung zeros, no? Walang value. So sir, Lassis, are you answering 393 or the previous item? Okay. So tandaan po natin, ha. So yung 00 pag nasa huli, pwedeng i-omit kasi walang value, just like letter B. Tingnan nyo. So yung letter C, hindi yan, the sign should not have been greater than but equal to. Okay, sir. Okay, Sir Lassis. Yes po, mali ako. Okay, it's okay, sir. No? Okay, kaya nga we're here to review, no? Alam ko naman na you already knew this one, but sometimes we need just to refresh, no? Okay. Next, 394. Jackie is 3 times as old as James. 3 times as old as James. How old is Jackie if their ages equals to 60? Sige nga. Okay, ito. So let X be the age of James. Sabi ka kanina, Jackie is 3 times as old as James. So 3X. So 3X plus X equals 60. Kasi the sum of their ages is equal to 60. Is equal to 60, right? Okay. So divide both side by 4. 4X divided by 4 is X. 60 divided by 4 is 15. So ang tanong, how old is Jackie if their ages equals to 60? So si Jackie is, ano? 45. Okay. Ano namang, ilang taong gulang naman si James? 15. Kasi si Jackie 3 times as old as James. So James should be 15 and Jackie is 3 times older than James. And the sum of their ages is 60. So Jackie is 45 years old and James is 15 years old. Okay. The sum of the three angles of a triangle is 180 daw. Okay. So teachers, you can just view this one, no? Anytime. And then pause if you are going to review. Okay. The sum of the three angles of a triangle is 180. One of the angle is twice the second. So yung first angle 2x, the second is x, and the third angle is 20 less than the second. So yung third angle is x minus 20 equals 180. Ito. So let 2x be the first angle kasi sinabi kanina yung first angle is twice the second, yung second angle is x, and then yung third angle sabi kanina is less than the second, 20 degrees less than. Okay. So 2x plus x plus x minus 20 equals 180. Transpose 20, negative, magiging positive. So 180 plus 20 is 200. Add like terms, 2x plus x, 3x plus another x, 4x. 4x equals 200, divide both sides by 4. 4x divided by 4 is x. 200 divided by 4 is 50. What is the measure of the largest angle? So, ang largest angle po ay 100. Okay. What is the measure of the largest angle? Yung second angle is 50. 150 na. Yung third angle, sabi kanina, less than 20 degrees the second. So yung second angle is 50 minus 20, 30, a total of 180 degrees. So the largest angle is 100. 2x times 50 is 100. X 50, 50 minus 20 is 30. So the first angle is 100, the second angle is 50, the third angle is 30, a total of 180. So the largest angle is 100 degrees, followed by the second angle, which is 50, and the last angle to make up the 180 measure of the angles of a given triangle, 30 degrees. Okay, next. He is a Russian novelist who wrote War and Anna Karenina. Oh, sino? Is it Isaac Babel? Ah. Okay, see? Leo Tolstoy. Okay. Leo Tolstoy. So sabi ni Leo Tolstoy, ang Anna Karenina daw ay his first true novel. Okay. His first true novel, according to Leo Tolstoy. Okay, very good. Next, 397, siya ay karakter sa No Limit Tanghere na sinasabing alam niya ang lahat, ngunit hindi ginagawa ang kanyang sinasabi. Okay, alam niya ang kanyang, oh, palagi ko, alam ko. 397, pilosopong tasyo. Take note. Okay, pilosopong tasyo. Okay, pilosopong tasyo. Sino si pilosopong tasyo sa tunay na buhay ni Rizal? Ang kanyang kapatid. No? Okay. Sige. Take note. Pilosopong tasyo po. Okay. Siya ang palaging nagsasabing, alam ko. Si Pilosopong Tasyo. Okay, si Pilosopong Tasyo. Sa yung karakter, no, sa Nole. At sa totoong buhay, siya ay si Pasiano, ang nakakatandang kapatid ng ating bayaning si Dr. Jose Rizal. Next item, 398, an orchid attached to a mango. Oh, ito, symbiotic relationship. An orchid attached to a mango tree is an example of, na-harm ba yung mango tree? No? Hindi. Naka-benefit ba yung mango? Yung orchid? Naka-benefit. Okay. Commensalism. Very good. Parasitism. Paano, ano yung parasitism? My host. Okay. And naka-benefit yung isa, na-harm naman yung host sa parasitism. Mutualism, both naka-benefit. Commensalism, naka-benefit yung isa without harming the other. Okay, very good. The Sahara Desert, 399. The Sahara Desert is the largest hot desert in the world located in... Oh, asa natatagpuan ang Sahara Desert? Desert. 399. Saan daw matatagpuan ang Sahara Desert? Saan matatagpuan? Very good. Sa Africa. Okay. Kung hottest ecosystem yung Sahara, ano naman yung coldest ecosystem? Coldest biome. Ano? Hottest biome, Sahara. The coldest biome is the tundra. Okay, very good. Next, 400. Okay. The longest river in the Philippines is longest river daw sa Pilipinas. Okay. Letter A, very good. The longest river in the Philippines is the Cagayan. Yung Agno po is the largest Philippine river. Okay? Take note. Pag sinabing longest, Cagayan. Pag sinabing largest, Agno. Okay? Sige. Pag sinabi nating hottest biome, Sahara. Pag coldest biome, Tundra. Okay. Longest river in the Philippines, Cagayan. Pag sinabi nating largest river in the Philippines, Agno. Very good. Okay, very good. Ma'am Avacon, yung Gilmore po, J, as in jar. Okay, next item. Tandaan po, longest river, Cagayan. Ay, taga Cagayan ka pala, ma'am Janice. Uy, wow, layo pala, no? Next, longest river po, Cagayan, largest is Agno. Okay, very good. Okay. Okay lang po, ma'am, Miss Avacon. Okay. Talagang palagi nagkakamali sila, no? Most particularly in writing my name. Gilmore instead of Gilmore. Okay, 401, plants create their own food by absorbing and processing sunlight. The ability to produce one's own food, na-discuss na natin to kanina, no? Autotrophy. Pag heterotrophy, dependent, no? Hindi makaproduce sa kanilang sariling pagkain. Okay. Okay. Pag sinabi nga ulit nating fungi, heterotroph yan. Pag sinabi nating algae, autotroph. Pag sinabi nating mga tanim, autotroph. Pag sinabi nating phytoplankton, autotroph. Very good. Most protozoas also are heterotrophs, no? Okay, very good. Next, which among the following properties is a measure of how easily a mineral can be scratched? O ano? Sige. Letter? Okay. How easily a mineral can be scratched? Very good po. Hardness. Okay. Pag sinabi po nating luster, ano nga ulit yung luster? Yung kumikintab. Okay. The property of materials to reflect lights, no? It shines. Okay. Tandaan po natin yan. Luster. Pag sinabi naman po nating malleability, can be hammered without breaking. Okay. Can be hammered into sheets, no, without breaking. Okay. Pag sinabi po nating elasticity. Pag sinabi nating elasticity, elastic, no, ability to expand but will return to its original form. Okay. Good. Okay. Yes, drawn into wire. Yes, very good. Next, which item 403? Which part of the earth is thought to be composed of iron and nickel? Iron and nickel daw. Lithosphere or core? So, ito, very easy lang. Core. Yung lithosphere po, nasa ibabaw. No? Hard surface. Composed of iron and nickel. Core. Letter B. Tandaan po natin yan. So, ang lithosphere po ay nasa surface. Solid outer part. Nasa surface po. Okay. Sige. Pag sinabi natin core, inside. Okay. Core. Sige. Next item. What is partially a molten layer of earth? It's cold. Partially molten layer. What is the partially molten layer of the earth? Cold. Partially molten. Asthenosphere or lithosphere? Oh, alam na natin ang sagot ito. Asthenosphere, partially molten. Okay? Kasi yung lithosphere, solid outer part, nasa labas. Yung asthenosphere naman, partially molten kasi almost liquid. Almost lang. Okay? Sige. Almost liquid. Okay. Very good. So, ang answer po ay asthenosphere. Okay, next. What does a pH below 7 indicate? O ito, pH level. Pag sinabi natin below 7, that is below 7, pH of less than 7 indicates what? Letter A, very good. Less than 7 gani ang pH, acidic. Pag above 7 gani to 14, that's basic or alkaline. Pag 7, neutral. Again, below 7, acidic. 7 above until 14, basic or alkaline. 7, neutral. Okay, next item. What is the term form slowing down response by the frog circulatory system during cold season? During cold season, anong tawag? Hibernation or estivation? Pag cold season, winter sleep, hibernate. Pag summer sleep, estivation. Take note po, hibernate, nangyayari tuwing cold season. Estivate, nangyayari tuwing summer. So, pag sinabi nating winter sleep, hibernate. Pag sinabi nating summer sleep, estivate. Okay? Winter sleep, hibernation. Summer sleep, estivation. Okay. So, low metabolic process during summer, estivation. Low metabolic process of animals during winter, hibernation. Very good. Tandaan po, summer, estivate. Winter, hibernate. Okay, next. Which of the following is an autotroph? Oh, autotroph daw, grasshopper, algae. Pag sinabi nating autotroph, organisms that produces their own food. O yung grasshopper, can it produce its own food? Hindi. So, 407, letter B, autotroph, algae. Tandaan. Pag autotroph, algae, and phytoplanktons. Okay, yan ay common examples, no? Ng autotrophs. Plants, algae, and phytoplanktons. Pag sinabi nating heterotroph, all sorts of animals and insects, fungi, heterotroph, and protozoa, autotrophs. Yan. Okay. Okay lang po, Ma'am Janice, no? At least alam na natin yung autotroph. It can produce its own food. Yung grasshopper, hindi, no? Kumakain lang yan ng mga palay or leaves, no, ng mga tanim, plants. Okay, so algae is an autotroph and phytoplanktons. Heterotroph, animals and insects, fungi, and protozoa. Okay, good. 407, famous sculptor and consider as the father of modern Philippine sculpture. Sino? Father of modern Philippine sculpture daw. Uy, gusto naman eh. Dali naman. Okay, 408. Okay, sino? Father of modern Philippine sculpture. Okay, sino? Abueva, Manansala, Amorsolo. Okay. Pag sinabi nating Amorsolo, grand old man of Philippine art, no? Yatong planting rice, yato. Pag sinabi nating Spularium, kay Juan Luna 'yan. Pag sinabi nating Manansala, legendary Philippine cubist or abstractionist of Philippine art scene. Amorsolo painting, yes. Okay. Grand old man of Philippine art, painting si Amorsolo. Pag sinabi nating father of modern Philippine sculpture, Abueva. Okay, very good. Okay, Abueva. Sige. Okay. Ito, carbon atom. In a carbon atom, yes, ma'am, Miss Avacon, Amorsolo is for painting. Yes. Philippine cubist, si Vicente Manansala, and father of abstractionism in the Philippine art scene. Okay, lay, paborito talaga ni Ma'am Avacon yung science and math, no? So, determine the number of neutrons. Okay, 6. Paano po? Take note, kasi 12 yung atomic mass and yung atomic number is 6, which is equal to the number of protons, which is equal to the number of electrons. Sinabi ko kanina, to get the number of neutrons, subtract the atomic mass, which is 12, by 6, which is equal to the number of protons. So the number of neutrons in a carbon atom is 6. Okay. Hindi po yung math. Okay. Sige lang, no? Basta hindi ka math major, elementary algebra lang naman yung part sa math, no? Kasi kaya nga kailangan nating mag-review kasi most of the times yung mga basic nakakalimutan na natin, no? Talaga. Okay. Take note. So, determine the number of neutrons, atomic mass, minus the number of protons. How to get the atomic mass? Add the number of neutrons and the number of protons. Okay. Very good. 410. Which is true about the atomic mass of an atom? Oh, is it equal to the sum of protons and electrons since both are equal? Letter B. Is it equal to the difference between the neutrons and protons? Or letter C. It is equal to the sum of neutrons and protons. So, ang sagot, atomic mass is the sum of neutrons and protons. So, ang sagot, letter C. Next, 411. Yes, 410 po. Letter C. Very good, Ma'am Ems. 410. The atomic mass is equal to the sum of the number of neutrons and protons. Okay, very good. 411. The ordering of the things according to importance. Ordering of things according to importance. Okay. Ordering of things according to importance. Ano? Okay, hindi ko po nakita ang 410. Ay, nawa. Okay, so ordering of things according to importance, that's the 411. Ano? 411. Ay, sagdi lang, Ma'am Avacon. Yung 410, balikan natin. Atomic mass lang. No, so that is the sum of the neutrons and protons. Okay, so hierarchy of needs, okay, by Abraham Maslow. Okay, ano daw yung pinaka highest, no, na pangangailangan ng tao according to the Maslow's hierarchy of needs? Self-actualization, sabi niya. Yung when a person realizes his or her potential or self-fulfillment. That's self-actualization. Very good. Okay. So, hierarchy of needs by Abraham Maslow. So, sabi niya, ang pinaka mataas na pangangailangan ng tao ay self-actualization. When a person realizes his or her own potentials, no, and self-fulfillment, self-development. Okay. Self-actualization. Very good, Ma'am Janice. Very good, Ma'am Avacon. Okay. Very good, Ma'am Lorimi. Okay. Very good. Abraham Maslow. Hierarchy of needs. Attacks imposed by state on land and structures. Oh, land and structures. Oh, klaro na. Real estate. No? Hindi naman individual income tax. Hindi rin inheritance tax. Kasi hindi naman nakalagay dyan na the land or the structures were inherited by you. So, real estate tax. Very good. O ito, the first Philippine micro-satellite orbiting Earth is 413. Sige. Letter C, Diwata 1. Letter D, Maganda 5. Letter A, Bathaluman. Letter B, Divina. Kinsa man kanis Divina. No? So very good. The first Philippine microsatellite orbiting the Earth is Diwata 1. A, the second. First, Diwata 1. Ano yung pangalawa? 2018 yata yun. No? Yes, 2018. Kasi itong Diwata 1 is 2016 na launch, no? E yung second is Diwata 2. Okay? First is the Diwata 1 and the second is Diwata 2. Diwata 2 was launched on October 29, 2018. Si Diwata 1 naman kay 2016. Okay? April 27, 2016. Si Diwata 2, kanus agan ito? Si Diwata 2, October 29. Oh, padung All Souls Day and All Saints Day. October 29, 2018. So, Diwata 1 kay April 27, 2016. 2 years after, Diwata 2 was launched. Okay. Next, 414. Which religious missionaries who arrived last in the Philippines? O kanina yung tanong, first. Ngayon naman, last to arrive. Okay, last to arrive. Ano? Correct. The Recollects. Afajadara. Okay. First were the Agustinians. Afa. F. Sec, followed by the Franciscans. Third, Afaja. Jesuits. Da. Dominicans. Ra. Recollects. Very good. Okay, ito. Lumalabas din to palagi sa let. Surface tension. Kanina yung tanong, no? Hindi ito yung kanina yung tanong, ang sagot ay surface tension. Ngayon naman, surface tension causes a paper clip. Kanina toothpick to float because of surface tension. Ngayon naman, surface tension causes a paper clip to sit on correct water surface. Okay, very good. Okay. Ito the last Governor General of the Philippines is sino? Letter, the last Governor General, si is it Izquierdo? Is it Basco? Or sino? Si Diego de los Reyes. Okay. Si Rafael Izquierdo, Z yan eh, I-Z Izquierdo. Sorry for the wrong spelling. Ito si Rafael Izquierdo is associated sa Cavite Mutiny, no? He was the one who ordered for the death, no, of the three martyred priests by strangulation. Okay. Si Jose Basco naman, tama si Ma'am Evacon, tobacco monopoly po. Okay. Ma'am Evacon, tama po, tobacco monopoly. Tobacco monopoly po si Jose Basco. Okay. Yan yung panahon na progresibo yung Pilipinas, no, during his time. Okay. So Rafael Izquierdo associated with the Cavite Mutiny, siya po ang nagpabitay, no? He ordered for the execution of the three priests Gomborza, no? Si Diego de los Reyes, last Governor General. Okay, very good. Next. Ma'am Avacon, I'm not really familiar with the term Majoha. Is it an acronym? Okay, let's proceed to item 417. Okay. Now, net income or profit results from, ano po ba yung net income or ano po bang resulta? Dahil sa ano ang net income or profit? Okay. Take note po, may profit pag yung revenues sobra kaysa sa expenses. Take note. So, ang sagot po dito sa 417 ay letter A. Net income or profit results from revenues exceeding expenses. Expenses. Take note. Pag sinabi naman po nating expenses exceeding revenues, that's loss. Ah, sir, yan po yung nasagot sa PBB regarding sa Gumbursa po. Ay, hindi ako nanonood ng PBB. Three Martyr daw po ay Majoha instead. Ay, nako. Gumbursa, Gomez, Borgo, Zamora. Talaga? Sagot, Majoha? Ano ba? Nako. Sige. Majoha daw. Okay. So, the three priests, ha? Gumbursa, hindi Majoha. Okay. So, it was Governor General Rafael Escuerdo who ordered, no, the execution of the three priests. Okay. Hindi nila alam. Siguro absent, no, nung nag-discuss yung teacher. Elementary man yan, no? Okay. Maybe absent. No? Kaya excuse siya nung nag-discuss si teacher sa tatlong pari na Gumbursa. Okay. Si Father Mariano Gomez, Jose Borgos, and Jacinto Zamora. Okay, next. So pag sinabi nating let's proceed, nakalimot. Yeah, maybe, no? So nakalimutan lang or baka na ano, they were just 'di ba 'yan? Nervous, no? Okay. So net income or profit results from, take note, revenues. May profit pag yung revenues sobra kaysa sa yung expenses. So, ginansya ka. Okay. Pag yung expenses mo naman eh sobra kaysa sa yung revenue, ay lugi ka. Loss ang tawag dyan sa economics. Okay. Take note. Pag assets naman exceeding liabilities, sobra-sobra yung asset mo kaysa sa mga babayaran mo, that's net worth. Okay? Pag liabilities naman, sobra-sobra pa yung babayaran mo kaysa sa yung asset, that's asset deficiency. Okay? So again, may profit pag revenues exceeds to that of your expenses. Loss naman or lugi if expenses exceeds to that of the revenues. Take note. Asset po exceeds liabilities, that's net worth. Pag liabilities exceeding assets naman, that's asset deficiency. Okay, very good. Sige. What law passed on August 1909 by the U.S. Congress established a partial free trade in the Philippines. Oh, partial free trade. Sagot, malapit na po tayong matapos, no? We only have 7 items left. Sige nga. Law passed by the US Congress, no? Partial free trade in the Philippines. Take note po, P, partial Payne-Aldrich Act. Pag full naman o yung katapat niya under Wood-Simons Act. Okay, full free trade na, no, ang ipinatupad ng Underwood-Simons Act. Pag partial free trade naman, Payne-Aldrich Act. Take note. Okay. Oy, teachers, nangatog na mo diha. Okay, known as the cradle of civilization. Ano? Known as the cradle of civilization. Is it Iraq, Sumerians, Akkadians, or Mesopotamia? Iraq is the modern-day Mesopotamia. Sumerians and Akkadians are just civilizations, no, that nourished or flourished in Mesopotamia, in the Fertile Crescent. So, ang sagot dyan, general Mesopotamia. Known as the cradle of civilization, Mesopotamia. Hala, maraming nagkakamali. May nagkakamali. Cradle of civilization, Mesopotamia po. Kasi yung Iraq and Sumerian Akkadians are just part of Mesopotamia. Okay? Civilizations in Mesopotamia. Diyan nagsimula ang sinaunang sibilisasyon sa Mesopotamia. Okay. Ito. The longest river in the world. 419, si Ma'am Janice Cruz, letter B. So, tandaan po natin ha, general statement po, kasi itong Iraq, Sumerians, and Akkadians are just part of Mesopotamia. So, pag things are part of a thing, dun ka sa general statement. Okay? Mesopotamia. Next po, longest river in the world. Okay, Nile. Pag wala po ang Nile, Amazon ang answer. Okay? Pero pag meron po ang dalawa, Nile ang piliin nyo. Okay. Yellow River po is the cradle of Chinese civilization. Take note. Yellow River. Okay. So, Amazon, largest. Okay. Katulad ng Agno. Okay. Pero pag wala po ang Nile River, longest river in the world, Amazon po ang isagot. Okay? Take note po. Pero pag andyan si Nile, Nile ang sagot. Okay. Very good. 421. Oh, ito. Nabalik na naman. She is known for the love sonnets she wrote. Love sonnets she wrote, Ofelia de Malanta. Okay. Paz Marquez Benitez is known for the first modern English Filipino short story written in English, Dead Stars by Paz Marquez Benitez, published in the Philippine Heralds in 1925. Okay, very good. The first Filipino novel in English. Oh, kung ang Dead Star ay first Filipino short story in English, ang Child of Sorrow, first novel. Take note. Child of Sorrow, first Filipino novel in English written by a Filipino, Zoilo Galang. Take note. Dead Stars, Paz Marquez Benitez. Modern Philippine English short story, Dead Stars. First Filipino novel in English, Child of Sorrow, published in 1921, Zoilo Galang. Take note. Okay. Siya ang tumulong kay Rizal upang maipalimbag ang Nole Metanghere. Tumulong upang maipalimbag ang Nole Metanghere. Sige, sino ang tumulong? Okay. Sino ang tumulong? B or C? Hala. Sino ang tumulong para maipalimbag ang Nole Metanghere? Okay. Sige. Si Man E. Okay. Pag sinabi nating El Felibus, El Viva. So pag El Felibus, Valentin Ventura. Pag sinabi nating No Limit Tanghere, tandaan, MVN, Maximo Viola, No Limit Tanghere. Okay. Pag sinabi nating El Feli, Viva, El Feli, Viva, Valentin Ventura. Pag sinabi nating No Limit Tanghere, sinong tumulong? Maximo Viola, MVN. Okay, very good. Good evening po. No? Sige. Sige, very good. Okay, the first legendary emperor of Japan. Lumabas ito noong 22. Let 2022. The first legendary emperor of Japan, Emperor Naruhito or Emperor Jimmu? Legendary emperor of Japan, the first legendary emperor of Japan. Sino? First legendary emperor of Japan. Sino? Okay, tandaan po natin na ang first legendary emperor of Japan ay si Emperor Jimmu, letter B. Okay? The first legendary emperor of Japan, Emperor Jimmu. Okay? Sige. Itong si Emperor Naruhito, naging emperor ng Japan no, just recently. And take note na all emperors claim no, to be descendants of Emperor Jimmu. And they believe that they are descendants of God. Okay? So first legendary emperor of Japan, Emperor Jimmu. Oy, baka biglang lumabas ito kasi lumabas ito noong 2022, no? At hindi ito lumabas na sa 2023. Okay. Emperor Jimmu, first legendary emperor. Sorry po, akala ko na ito. Legendary sanin? Sino? Si Jiraiya ba? Si Tsunade ba? Or si Orochimaru ba? Legendary sanin ng Konoha, no? Legendary emperor of Japan, Emperor Jimmu. Ikaw talaga, Ma'am Abacon. Alam mo pala na paborito ko ang Naruto. Ha? Sige. Take note. Last item. Tandaan po natin, first legendary emperor of Japan, hindi po legendary sanin ng Konoha, legendary emperor of Japan, Emperor Jimmu, letter B. Okay. Next, the first Islamic missionary to arrive in the Philippines. Okay. First Islamic missionary to arrive in the Philippines. Sino? Sige. Abu Bakar or Makdum Karim? Sige. First Islamic missionary to arrive in the Philippines. But my question mark, miss. Okay, take note po. First missionary. Ang unang nagtatag ng Sultanato ng Sulu, si Abu Bakar. Unang nakarating ang Islam sa Pilipinas dahil sa isang misyonaryo, no, galing Saudi Arabia, si Makdum Karim. Okay, take note po. Ang nagtatag ng Islamic Sultanate of Sulu, Abu Bakar. Pag sinabi nating first Islamic missionary to arrive in the Philippines, that's Makdum Karim. Okay? So, teachers, this ends our Friday night drills. Okay? So okay lang po Ma'am Janice, no? At least okay, kaya nga nandito tayo. Tandaan natin, first Sultanate of Sulu, siyang nagtatag ng first Sultanate and he claimed himself as the first Sultan Abu Bakar. Okay? First Islamic missionary Makdum Karim. Okay, take note. So thank you po sa mga nanatili, no? At tumatangkilik sa ating Friday Night Drills. Salamat po for trusting LCTC, no? So sa mga kakilala niyong pumasa na, send them a congratulations, no? No? And alam ko na papasa rin kayo ngayong March. Okay? So salamat at salamat, salamat ng marami. Okay? So see you next week again, teachers, okay? Same time. See you again next Friday sa Friday Night Drills here at LCTC Review Center. This is me again, Sir Gilmore, for our Friday Night Drills. Now signing off. Thank you so much, everyone, and goodbye.